hollow. Hey, how goes it? Are the children all right?
Hi. Poison takes to the air around these fields outside. Beware,
I should be able to resupply here.
In the soil, the air, the water, the red rock is everywhere.
Strong.
That won't stop me from praying for our survival.
How's with you?
We've taken our paradise for granted. The blight, the famine, they are retribution.
Careful, Outlander. These fields are wrought with blight.
May the sun shine upon you. May your day be fruitful.
We've got our eyes on you, visitor. By the look of you, you must be an Easterner. It's been some time. Good.
How do you do? How do you do?
In good health?
May the land bloom.
Sun shine upon you.
Wind carry.
An Outlander in plain song. You'll want to talk to me if you plan. My people may be peaceful, but the machines that plague our lands are not. Those of us willing to fight train at the hunting grounds northwest of here.
That's good to hear. I might stop by if I'm in the area.
May you walk in the fields of plenty. We are honored to meet a huntress such as you. Charming and...
Hunting Outlander.
Day.
Pretty bad.
We'll do a half day today, but tomorrow we start early.
Land was bracing for this rain.
Won't meet with me. I don't know what else to do.
How about you just start by telling me what's wrong?
I'm from Riverhem, to the north. A few days back, I woke to the screams of my neighbors as Tanakh's rebels attacked. They were just scouts, but we barely drove them off. If a full raiding party comes next, we're not fighters. We're done for. I thought the chorus would help us. I thought we all sprouted from the same earth, but it seems an outlander is the only one who even listened to me. Would it be too much to hope that you'd stand with us in this fight?
Regala's rebels, do you know why they're attacking you?
You're asking why the sun sets at night. They are Tanakh. They live to fight. As usual, among themselves. But this time, my village is caught in the middle. The rebels want to strip it of supplies to feed their campaign against the Western clans.
They're not attacking here. Can't you retreat to Plainsong?
An outlander might find it difficult to understand. All Utaru carry seeds that are planted when we pass. My people have planted many seeds in Riverhim's Grove, a gift from the Barriedeers. Which I believe outlanders call the Red Raids. We'll never leave. We sacrifice too much.
You said your own people won't help.
The Khors are supposed to speak for all Utaru. And normally I wouldn't question them. But they see outlying settlements like Riverhem as lost lands, no longer under Plainsong's protection. They won't even meet with me to discuss it.
If I find myself up north, I'll check in on your people.
I ask nothing more. When you reach the village, look for Q. He's heading up our defenses.
Aloy, wasn't sure you'd ever come around. What do you think of Plainsong?
It's quite a place.
Sure. As long as you like the smell of manure. Ah, don't mind me. I won't go wandering again, I promise. There are people who need me here. Some of the others the Eclipse took had it worse than me. A lot worse.
Do what you can for them, Yev.
I will. It won't be anything like you did, but I'll give it my best.
Thank you.
Yes?
Light is worse.
Huh?
We have to stand firm, especially for the children.
Don't shy away from trying to lead the eyes with that heart of conscience. You're a Nora, aren't you? I haven't seen one since I visited Hunter's Gathering.
I didn't think the Utaru traveled that far east.
I did it for my dyes. I like to see how different tribes use roots and plants to make new colors. It's amazing how the right hue can make armor express so much more than its mere function. I have some samples, if you're interested.
Beautiful.
It's nothing compared to the Tanakh Dyers. They may not be the friendliest of tribes, but if you bring their dyers plants or samples, they might show you their skills.
I'll keep an eye out for them.
Often she went to the old woman, longest lived in the forest. She would look up from the